Season is here. It's here. I'm so excited. I know you are excited. The team's excited. What's been going through your mind this week as you prepare for the first game?
It's crazy to think that it's almost been a year since we have been on the field. The team is just really energized, ready, enthusiastic, just to get on the field on Saturday. And I think that once Saturday comes, I keep saying 11 a.m., once we're doing our warm-up, I can finally take a deep breath that it's actually happening. The girls really have just been working extremely hard this preseason, and it's been the most fun I've ever had in a preseason. They're ready to work. They've realized how much we've probably taken it for granted in the past, honestly. After the season got cut short last year, it was devastating. So they really haven't taken any times for granted right now in this last 3.5 week preseason. They've really been working hard and every day getting better and more energized and ready to be there.
You touched on how this has been the most fun you've had during a preseason. Why is that? I know you alluded to just because of the season getting cut short, but are there things that you're seeing from your players where you're like, wow, like, it looks like they want to, you know, be there at 7 a.m. for conditioning? Like, what are you seeing?
Well, like I said, you know, no one's taking any time on the field right now for granted. Everyone's asking for extra reps. The competition at practice is the best I've ever seen it. They're really challenging us every single day when we're talking about, you know, who's our starting 12 right now? Every day is a new group. So I love that. I love when they're challenging me with that. It means that they're working really hard and they're pushing each other. Every day at practice, we are getting so much better as a whole group. You know, I think defense has always been our strong side. Right now, our offense is really coming together and working wonderfully together as a unit. And our defense is kind of a little shocked, like, oh gosh, how do we handle this right now? And it's fun to see because it's really challenging them.
Let's talk about some of the pieces here. And starting with defense, what should we expect from the defense? Sierra Street is back, which is tremendous. What's the defense looking like here?
Defense is they're go-getters. You know, they're really aggressive. They're really hungry for the ball. We're doing a lot better with competing for ground balls right now inside. All those 50-50 balls we're doing a much better job with. Having that leader in Sierra Street back is really awesome. And Emmy Fluman as a senior too. Just both those young ladies who have been a part of this program for either 4 or 5 years. It's great to have them back to just help out with these underclassmen. And our underclassmen are doing a great job of buying in.
Megan Biazzi is there's no way around it. She's incredible. I mean, she looked great as a freshman, and the things that you told me about her in the off season. I mean, her game is just risen. For someone that doesn't know about her game, like, what does she bring to the table as a goalie?
She is one of the most composed goalies. I said this last year to her as a freshman as well, but she is one of the most composed goalies I've ever worked with. And the best thing about Megan is when she's coming up with these unbelievable saves, right when she's done saving the ball, she looks at that attacker and says, hey, this is what you should do next time to make sure you score. She wants her teammates to have success. She's helping them. I've never seen someone who constantly is giving feedback to their teammates of how to be able to get the ball in the back of the net on her. She really just is a remarkable player. She actually was voted as a team captain this year as well and was a preseason second team all conference. Every day at practice, she's getting better. And she's someone, especially when she was having such a great beginning freshman year, it really burned for her for the season to be cut short for her. And so now she's just hungry. She's ready to go. She is fired up.
Offensively, you bring back a good number of people, including Kendall Wells. What do you think is going to contribute the most offensively in terms of, you know, trying to get goals? Are you looking for X number of passes, working the ball around before you can get a shot, or like what's the mindset on the offensive end?
We are very versatile on the offensive side. The nice thing is we have a lot of returners on the attack side. You know, with Nina Cifalilli finally back, Kendall Wells, her fifth year, Annie Plotz, who had an injury towards the end before COVID hit, Kaylee Hiles. Freshman year, it's always hard to really truly rely on freshmen to you know, they get that, they have to go over that freshman bump a little bit of it's hard to have super high expectations for them. Kaylee and Annie are in their groove right now. They're ready to go. They're finishing the ball really, really nicely right now and really adapting to the team culture on the offensive side, whereas everybody is a threat. There's seven players on the attack side. All seven of the players on the field are a threat. It's not just Kendall Wells and Annie Plotz. It's all seven of them. They are a force right now, and it's very fun to watch them play.
What did you take away from this off season? Leah mentioned just a lot. It was a challenge to stay engaged, but she said she found ways to stay engaged. What did you learn about yourself as a coach during this time to try and keep your ladies locked in and know that it's going to come a time when we're going to play, and now is that time?
I try and lead as much as I can by example, and I think if COVID did anything for me personally in my profession is to not take any time for granted with our team. And I feel really fortunate enough that we have bounced back as well as we have and that we're competing this weekend. I feel really blessed that we're at this spot right now. I emailed parents this week and said, it's finally game week. It's actually here. Mm-hmm. So not taking time for granted. Don't get me wrong. There's times where when we're out at 7 a.m. in the morning and it's cold, sometimes it's hard to be there. But I feel blessed when I walk on that field every day for practice. I feel blessed to be with these 28 young ladies every single day. And I feel like this is one of the best, most talented groups we've had, and they're finally starting to realize it. So it's so fun, and because that practice for them too, even when it's cold and bitter to be outside, they're jacked up to be there too. So because I've been trying to lead that way, that don't take any time for granted, don't take practices for granted, they've been jumping on board with that. They've been jumping on board with that culture and that change that we're trying to make, that to recognize that we're blessed to be here. There's a lot of teams that aren't even having team practices right now, and we are. So I try and remind them that daily, that we are so lucky where we are and that we're competing. So like I said, this off season for me has just been a time of reflecting on how passionate I am about what I do and how blessed I feel to be a part of this wonderful program.
Last one, what would you like to see from your team? What do you need to see from your team this weekend in game one to come away with a victory?
Adjustments. Make adjustments early, and that's been our biggest struggle as a program, is just making the adjustments quickly. And I think that we're at a better place now, that once we make that adjustment that we need to right when the game starts off, we're going to be in a good spot. And so again, making adjustments quickly, making sure we're working together and not getting rattled. You know, there's going to be times that we might be down by a goal or two. That's okay. Next one. We got that next one. Yeah. So I think that's the biggest mentality is recognizing, you know, this is also a mental game, that we have to recognize that we're still very much in a game, and don't let those last two plays affect the rest of the game. Move on, and let's make sure we keep battling every play.
Coach, good luck. We can't wait.
Thank you.